Connections, refractions, plural nouns, 6 degrees of separation, a butterfly beats his wings in Japan, and a man flies a plane into the World Trade Center. There's a orangutan on my newsfeed, and he's got everyone up in arms. He's telling us to boycott palm oil, and it's raising serious alarms in my head. This is about the banned Iceland commercial, which purports to raise awareness about endangered species in Borneo. You've all seen it. It's the cute little orangutan voiced by National Treasure Emma Thompson. Let's take a look.
There's a orangutan in my bedroom and I don't know what to do. She plays with all my teddies and keeps borrowing my shoe.
Now, I have to say that I've always been ambivalent about third world development. It's that old chestnut, give a man a fish, feed him for a day. Teach a man to fish, you fuck up the ecosystem. We've taught the farmers of Borneo to plant palms, and this has happened. Dead fucking baby monkeys at Christmas. Nice one. As soon as I saw this, the famed O'Sullivan bullshit detector started going bananas, if you'll pardon the play on words. I decided to do a little digging O'Sullivan style. My first port of call was Clearcast, the people who banned the ad. Oh, how's it going? It's Donny O'Sullivan here calling from Channel 4's The O'Sullivan Report. Okay, it's basically it's just one question. It's just why was it banned?
Okay, yes, if you could pop that in an email for us, just so that we have your details from that as well, and then I'll be able to speak to the comms team and get in touch with you as soon as possible.
Okay, that's fine. The only thing is that when it's done by email, it doesn't make for as good television. So I was just wondering if you could just say something. It was time to get the other side of the story. I went down to the Iceland embassy, dressed as an orangutan. Why? Because I've got a Planet of the Apes mask.
Very interesting. They're trying to send us off in a different direction.
We're just around the corner from the Embassy of Iceland. I've got a few questions to ask them.
It's Donny O'Sullivan from the O'Sullivan Report. Channel 4 is the O'Sullivan Report. And we just wanted to talk to the ambassador about the banned Iceland ad.
Does he know what he's talking about?
Well, sort of. I did have a phone conversation. We kind of left it open. I said I might pop around.
Okay. So should we, if you want to take a seat, I'll go and give him a call.
Okay, great. Right. Doesn't seem like anybody wants to talk to me.
So, and he's actually coming to a meeting now. He just said he wasn't
aware. Okay. I find that interesting because I did talk to him. I talked to him earlier. Yeah, it was that this was all a publicity stunt from Iceland. So I just wanted to know if I could get a comment on that. Right, okay, you can't, okay. No, I do understand that. Obviously, you know, you didn't commission the ad. But I don't know if you want to, give me a statement.
No, I'm sorry,
anything at all.
I know absolutely nothing, so I'm not going to comment, sorry.
Okay. Have you seen the ad?
No, sorry, are you recording right now?
Are you recording? Well, I find that very interesting. They obviously didn't want to talk to me. My presence in the waiting room of the consulate was making them very, very uneasy. The girl at reception said she didn't know anything about it, which I find weird because there's 13 million people who've seen the ad on Facebook. And the ambassador point blank refused to have a conversation with me. Right, okay, well, new information has just come to light. Actually, Iceland is actually also a supermarket. So we're going to go and check that out now. Let's go. Sorry, can you not hear me? Sorry. We're doing a... this is the O'Sullivan Report for Channel 4 News.
Okay.
It's about the banned Iceland ad.
Yeah.
About the orangutans. I know that's more of a chimpanzee.
We don't know anything about that, actually. We basically work here.
Help. Okay. Sorry. Sustainable palm. To use palm oil, there's palm. Okay, I need to talk to somebody about that. I just wonder if you'd like to give me a statement about
apparently you don't use palm oil, but I've just found a product here with it says sustainable palm. Can you hear me?
Sorry.
Iceland have put out an ad saying that they don't use palm oil, but I've just found this clover and it says sustainable palm. So I just wondered if you'd like to comment on that. Sorry. No, I'm not buying it. No. I was hoping that I'd get chucked out. Excuse me. Sorry, do you want me to leave? Okay, we're leaving.
Well, they've eventually asked me to leave. It took quite a long time, but they must have got a phone call or something, because that guy was fucking pissed. He looked fucking mad, like he was going to kill me. Right, I've got a lot of thinking to do. I'm going to go home. I'm going to do a bit of research.
I discovered that the ad had originally been commissioned by a shady organisation known as Greenpeace. They had actually been playing the ad for 3 months before Iceland got involved. What the fuck was going on? And they're not above resorting to violence to get their own way, as some harmless Japanese dolphin fishermen can attest to. Why the fuck is Iceland getting into bed with these people? And what is the agenda? As always, follow the money.
Good afternoon, Greenpeace.
Hello. I'm an investigative journalist. And I just wanted to ask, who funds you?
Okay.
Okay. Can you give me the names of any of those individuals?
I'm not sure if we're allowed to.
Okay. You have been described as eco-terrorists. Do you have any comment on that?
Just bear with me for a moment, sir.
Oh, that's apparently a joke.
Hello, are you there, sir?
Oh, hi. Yeah, hello.
I'm just going to pop you through to a gentleman called Jack.
Okay. Hi, is that Jack?
Yes.
Jack, how you doing? It's Donny O'Sullivan here from the O'Sullivan Report. Can I just ask you one thing?
Go ahead.
It's just, have you any comment on, some people have described Greenpeace as eco-terrorists.
I can't give any official comments.
Okay. Fucking hell, mate, my fucking head is exploding. I've just been given the New York runaround by Greenpeace. They were interestingly unable to deny that they are eco-terrorists. But what really has got to me is that I was kept on the phone for a long time and they were probably tracking my call. And I'm fucking shitting it now that they know where I live and that I'm onto them. So I've just destroyed my cell phone and I've taped up my laptop. And I've written a letter to my mate Chalky, saying if anything happens to me to bring the contents to Channel 4 News. What the fuck was that? I've just found a name on the Greenpeace website which has walloped me between the eyes. Jane Fonda, patron. So Jane Fonda is behind all this. Why is that name familiar to me? Connections, refractions, plural nouns, 6 degrees of separation. A butterfly beats its wings in Japan and a man flies a plane into the World Trade Center. In 2004, Jane Fonda made a film called Tell Them Who You Are with a co-star, one Paul Newman. And there it fucking is, the smoking gun. Because what is Paul Newman famous for? Oh, just a rather popular brand of fucking sauces. Let's have a little read of the ingredients. No prizes for guessing what isn't in there. Rapeseed, yes. Olive oil, yes. No fucking palm oil. This is almost fucking amateurish in its obviousness. Get the whole world up in arms about palm oil and orangutans so that nobody buys products with palm oil. Ergo, the products that don't contain palm oil, the few products that don't contain palm oil, fly off the shelf. We're looking at a fucking potential £1 billion conspiracy here. I mean, I haven't done the maths, I'm not a mathematician, but everybody eats salad dressing. What you have to understand is that the media is structured like a Russian doll. Inside one story, there's an even bigger story. I know that's smaller than that, but... And inside that story, there's another even bigger story. And you've got to keep digging until you get right to the heart of it. And sometimes you never even do. Connections, refractions, plural nouns, 6 degrees of separation. A butterfly beats his wings in Japan, and a man flies a plane into the World Trade Center.